In this video, I'll be showing you how to seamlessly integrate GitHub Copilot into Xcode, transforming your development experience. Whether you're a seasoned pro or just starting out, this step-by-step guide will walk you through the process from setting up the necessary dependencies to unleashing the full power of Copilot within Xcode. Get ready to supercharge your productivity and make coding a breeze. Let's jump right into it and unlock the potential of GitHub Copilot for your iOS and macOS development projects. Check out the link in the description for a 50% off Cyber Monday sale. Go ahead, it's down over there. And today we are going to talk about how to add GitHub Copilot into Xcode. Now, this has been a really, really anticipated feature. I have already added Codeium into Xcode. If you want to check that out, the video will be all the way up here in the information cards. Now, today we are going to add GitHub Copilot. Now, you can add GitHub Copilot already to VS Code. But you cannot add it natively into Xcode. So how to do that? We are going to cover just that. Let's just go into GitHub. And if you haven't already done so, go ahead and select Copilot right over here. Of course, you do need to have a GitHub account. And if you haven't already signed up for GitHub Copilot, go ahead and do so. They have 1 month free. The first month is free. And this is what you are going to be greeted with. And what we are going to do is just, first of all, talk a little bit about a small little hack that you can use without any additional installation. So what we are going to do is you have to have Visual Studio Code installed onto your Mac and also, of course, Xcode. And we are going to use the Visual Studio Code integration. So let's just click on this right over here. And you want to download the GitHub Copilot extension. So let's just click again over here and click on install over there, continue and allow that. So Visual Code Studio has been opened and I already have this installed onto my computer. So as you can see, it's right over here and this little icon right over here. So just install it. Okay, so next up, what you want to do, just want to follow along how you want to add Copilot. Let's just go over here. Oh, not that link, sorry. Just go back over there, this link. So you just want to, a pop-up will appear asking to open Visual Studio Code. Okay, go for the extensions, all of that. And then authorize to approve, confirm the authentication. You just go through all of these steps and you will be just fine with Visual Studio Code. Now, how does that look like? Well, let's just create. And this is kind of the hack what we are going to do to have GitHub Copilot in Xcode. Let's just create a new Xcode project and we are going to work in Visual Studio Code with the code completions and we are going to kind of save everything and see if it looks good and works within Xcode. So let's create a new project right over here. Let me just resize this real quickly. To celebrate Cyber Monday, I'm thrilled to announce a spectacular 50% off sale on all my products, including the highly acclaimed SwiftUI Camp. Whether you're diving into SwiftUI development or looking to elevate your coding skills, now is the perfect time to grab these incredible resources at half the price. Don't miss out on this limited time opportunity to supercharge your learning journey and enhance your app development prowess. The link is down in the description. Happy coding! App, iOS, that's right. Click on next right over here. Let's drop it onto the desktop, that's fine. Okay, so now that we have this, let's get rid of the canvas so we can see the actual code. So let's just switch onto Visual Studio Code and let's open up the root of our folder. So let's go onto the desktop and here we go. Let's open this. Okay, yes, I trust this. And then let's open up our content view. There we go. We have our content view. And yeah, just have a new line right over here. And as you can see, it's suggesting to add a padding. Let's hit tab to accept that code completion. And then what we want to do is save. So we just go under the file and save. Yes, and then all of this will be saved, and just switch onto your Xcode project, and it has been added right over here. Now, this is a little bit hacky, and many of us, including myself, don't really like to work on Xcode, like iOS, Apple framework projects inside VS Code. Yeah, there are some good things about Xcode that VS Code doesn't have, like the auto-completion, and well, it does have auto-completion, but Xcode is Xcode. Also, you have to export this to the App Store within Xcode. The final destination will always be Xcode. And you want to just switch between those two programs, it's fine, but it's not ideal. Therefore, I want GitHub Copilot to be inside Xcode. So let's do that. For that, let's just go and search for Copilot for Xcode. There we go. And it's this GitHub repository. So it's from int. Oh, I'm simply not going to go that way. So go ahead and take a look at the URL right over here. It's the same guy or gal, we don't know, that has the other GitHub repository for Codium. Actually, Codium for Xcode is a fork from Copilot for Xcode. So this is what we want to choose. And yeah, as you can see, there's quite a lot going on right over here. Let's go through the installation. So we can just use Homebrew, but we can just simply go to the releases page, open in the new tab there. And as you can see, it's quite updated. Last week is the latest release. So let's just click over here and download it. Okay, once you download it, you want to put it into your applications folder. So let's do that. Just move this a little bit up over here and drag and drop it from there. There we go. Great, so we have Copilot right over there. Let's move forward and let's see what do we want to do. So open the app. The app will create a launch agent to set up a background running service that does the real job. Okay, so after we added that into the applications folder, let's double click on it. It will just open it up. Let's click on open. We trust that. I always just select automatically download and install updates and check automatically. So next up, we want to allow this Copilot for Xcode extension service to be used by accessibility. So let's open system settings right over there. And you want to check this one. Let's just enable that. And that's right. Okay. I think I already did this. Okay, so let me just move this right over here so we can see it. Great. So we did enable that for accessibility, but we want to also set up our source editor as the Copilot. So let's just go back to our system settings again. Right over here, system settings, and just go to privacy and security and just scroll all the way down to extensions. And then there is this Xcode source editor and just select Copilot. Never mind about this. This is just my dummy extension that I was working with. So this Copilot will appear here. Make sure that you check that. And that's the step there. Okay, granting permissions. Yes, we already did this. And yeah, you can set up key binding. So what we are going to do right now is just close Xcode. Let's just quit Xcode and open it up again. Okay, let's just wait for that. There we go. And then you want to go Xcode settings. Let me just move this over here. And under the key bindings, if you just type Copilot, you will see all of the optional key bindings that you can add in there. I'm not going to bother for now with this, but it's really, really great to have those shortcuts set up. And you can choose all of these, what you have over here, because they are not going to conflict with other stuff. So let's see. I believe that, no, that's not it. We want to set up the GitHub Copilot client. So in the host app, navigate to service GitHub Copilot. Let's do that. Let's just go into the host app. So we want to go under the service and then GitHub Copilot. And then you want to install this Vim version. Okay, let's just install that. Downloading, it has been installed. Next up, I believe we want to sign in. Let's see. Yes, click on sign in and you will be redirected to a verification website provided by GitHub. Okay, let's click on sign in right over there. Okay, the code has been copied into our clipboard. So what we need to do is hit Command V and it will just paste it right over there. Let's continue there. Authorize GitHub Copilot plugin. Congratulations, you're all set. Let's go back to Copilot for GitHub. As you can see, this is the alert that, okay, it has been copied into the clipboard. Let's click OK right over there. And then you want to click on Confirm Sign In. And that's, the status is okay, really, really great. Let's see what's up next. Let's go all the way to our documentation. Okay, after signing in, you want to confirm the sign-in. Okay, go to feature suggestions and update the feature provider to GitHub Copilot. Okay, so feature and suggestions. You might have Codeium right over here, but by default, we have GitHub Copilot, so that's already in there. Okay, and yeah, you can set up Codeium if you choose to. Also, you can set up ChatGPT for the chat feature, but that we are going to cover in my next video. So now let's just check it out. Let's see, let's go into Xcode. Let's close this because we don't need that at all. Let's just see if we are going to have some sort of a suggestion. Let's just hit dot right over here. And there we go. We have our suggestion. So foreground style dot secondary. Let's accept that. Maybe just for a new line. Let's see if it's going to suggest anything. And let's hit dot right over there. Again, it's suggesting that I add font.title. And yeah, it's really, really great. Now we have Copilot inside our Xcode projects, which is much, much more streamlined than just going back and forth between Visual Studio Code and Xcode. Now, if you did like this tutorial, go ahead and check out my sale on Cyber Monday. The link again is down in the description. And make sure to check out how you can do all of this without a GitHub Copilot subscription for free with Codeium. Go ahead and check out, the link is right over here.